Morning, everybody. Christian here with River Pools. The last time you saw me, I was explaining why and where on your pool woven roving and honeycomb are used. In today's episode, the pool is complete. We're gonna pop it off the mold. We're gonna trim it. We're going to inspect it. We're gonna log our records, and I'm gonna explain why in the world we would weigh the pool. Welcome to episode 6 of How Fiberglass Pools Are Made. So I just got word we're about to go pop the pool off the mold. Let's take a ride on the golf cart over there, because I can't resist a ride on the golf cart. We're gonna put 4 straps, 4 chains connected to the pool. Pick it up off the mold. This is what we're looking for. We're looking for a very even release. Okay, now that was a pool that just lifted cleanly off the mold. Matthew's gonna carry this over with a telehandler. We're gonna set it up on some foam blocks and get ready to trim all the excess fiberglass off the edges. Okay, so Matthew is about to come out. He's gonna trim that pool that we just popped off the mold. And what Matthew's gonna do is he's gonna use a skill saw to cut off all the excess fiberglass. Matthew is gonna put on a face shield and a respirator. He's gonna have a full Tyvek. So what Matthew's gonna do is he's gonna grab his saw. Matthew is gonna be wearing gloves. What I'm saying is that Matthew's gonna be doing this and not me. It's not a very desirable. Matthew. Matthew. I'm glad it wasn't me. There's Matthew, he's got the pool. We're gonna set it up on a couple saw horses. He's gonna get it washed out, do initial inspection. Once he gets it set up, we'll ask him what are the 3 things he's looking for during this initial inspection. Okay, so this pool has been washed inside and out. Matthew's gonna perform 2 inspections on this pool today. 1 with it upside down, 1 with it right side up. Matthew, what are the 3 things you're looking for during these inspections?
I'm looking for consistency in the gel coat. I'm looking for spider cracks. I'm also looking for any signs of wear and tear due to the mold.
Very good. How do we know if the gel coat is consistent in a pool mold?
Oh, with the light?
In a pool.
With the light, you'll be able to see from the outside in, you'll see some light and be able to see the uprights of the honeycomb remnants, and you'll also be able to see light going through.
So he's looking for thin spots in the gel coat and the laminate using sunlight coming through the mold. If we can see dark and light patches, it would mean inconsistent gel coat. I have something in my eye. Inconsistent gel coat and an inconsistent thickness in the laminate. How does this pool check out?
This pool looks great.
Fantastic. All right, spider cracks. How do we assess for spider cracks in this inspection and the next one?
Well, I want to look around all the main stress points, mainly all the copings and the edges of the tanning ledges.
Very good. And how does this pool check out?
Well, the mold has been repaired, so it looks great.
Fantastic. Which brings me to my last point. How would you know from a pool shell that the mold itself might be in need of repair?
You'll be able to see some leftover red flecks in the pool from the existing gel coat on the mold.
Okay, so that would indicate that the mold itself, the gel coat on the mold, is beginning to break down, because over time, after multiple runs of production on a mold, all of the heat generated during the curing process begins to break down that gel coat. And there are times where we have to pull a mold off the production, make some repairs to it, get it ready to go to shoot and produce more pools. Okay, so Matthew's gonna go take this pool, we're gonna get it flipped over, he's gonna perform the inspection again. I'm gonna take you inside and show you the records we keep on every pool we manufacture. Let's flip to that pool we just popped off the mold. What do we record? Temperature of the air, temperature of the mold, how much gel coat is used, how much vinyl ester resin, how much polyester resin. We record the catalyst percentage for each one. We also test gel time for gel coat, vinyl ester resin, polyester resin, because we want to make sure the catalyst ratio is perfect based on that day's environmental conditions. Why do we keep all of these records? To ensure our equipment and materials are performing consistently. To ensure we are producing a consistent product. To ensure that the pool we designed is the one that gets built. How can you verify the manufacturer of your pool does the same? Ask for this. A dig sheet. It not only shows the dimensions and specs of your pool, but it also indicates what the final weight should be after the pool is trimmed. Compare the weight indicated on the spec sheet to the weight actually recorded and logged on the side of your pool. If the number on the side of your pool is within 5% of that indicated on the dig sheet, you're in good shape. It only means your pool was built as designed with the right amount of material. So, how likely is it that manufacturers do not produce pools within 5% of the weight indicated on the dig sheet? Very likely. Long before River Pools was a manufacturer, we were installers. And when pools would arrive at the job site, we would weigh them. Many times we would find that the actual weight was as much as 20% lower than that indicated on the dig sheet. Now that we've covered all that, let's go see what that Oasis 27 actually weighs. Our dig sheet indicates, by design, it should weigh 2,180 pounds. If you were a betting man, I'm calling 2120. What's your final number?
2121.
Ooh, a Price is Right, man. Let's see how wrong he is.
Let's see what that Oasis 27 actually weighs. Our dig sheet indicates by design it should weigh 2,180 pounds.
Let's see what the final verdict is up there. 2170.
That makes me the winner.
Joker. Good job to Matthew and all the guys in the back for building such a quality pool that landed so close to the final weight. I mean, 10 pounds that's unreal. I didn't bet any money on that, thankfully. If you've been following along in this video series so far, now you know how to build your own fiberglass pool. Well, you at least know how your fiberglass pool is made. After today's video, you now know how we pop the pool off of the mold. You know how we trim the excess fiberglass off the pool. You know what we inspect for on the pool. You know why we keep records and what records we keep. And you know why we weigh the pool. Goodness, I love a good afternoon nap out here by the pool. Listen, I hope today's video has been helpful for you. We're going to continue producing educational content for pool shoppers, for pool owners. The channel is absolutely worth subscribing to, so hit that red button down below. In the next episode, we're going to package that pool up. We're going to deliver it out to a job site, and I'm going to show you how we use Rhino Rock construction methodology to install that pool safely in the ground where it will forever remain. I'm Christian with River Pools. We'll see you next time on How Fiberglass Pools Are Made. Catch the wave.